Welcome back to On Point. Three 85-point races up for grabs this weekend. UK looks to go 30-0. James, can you go 3-0 on these races?
I'm going to try.
All right, yeah, there's some good ones. Got the Gotham, Tampa Bay Derby, and the San Felipe. 255 points in total. Obviously, everyone gunning for the 50 points that each of the winners will receive. I'm not even sure where to start, James. So much great racing this weekend. I guess we'll go where the big horse is, or at least the big horse on many people's poll. Dortmund, San Felipe. It's not a race I think he needs to win to necessarily, obviously, stay on the Derby trail, but all eyes are going to be on him.
Yeah, he's essentially in the same spot that Upstart was in the Fountain of Youth, where he won his first prep of the year. He's still got one race remaining before the Derby, so how hard he's been trained for this race is to be determined, I guess, but he's still the horse to beat, clearly.
Yeah, and you know, there was some talk of he didn't show up here. My experience, and it's anecdotal right now, I probably have to do a little more research before I go to the windows on it, but it seems like when Baffert springs sort of, all right, we're going to this race, the horse is ready. He's not there to get one under his belt. And earlier we were talking with Steve Bick, my pick in the race, Ocho Ocho Ocho, actually might need a race. I'm still sticking with him, but I know you feel differently.
Yeah, I'm against Ocho Ocho Ocho. He's drawn down inside as well as Lord Nelson, another contender in the field. But I like Prospect Park. I'm going to box him in an exacta with Dortmund, but I think he's ready to run a big race for size. I like the improving form.
Yeah, and we put on Twitter some stats. The inside going a mile and a 16th has not been the place to be at Santa Anita. Maybe the undefeated stakes winners are good enough to overcome it. I'm interested to see how Bolo does on the dirt. Those turf starts have been really great, but Ocho 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 is my tab on top. I guess we'll go to the East Coast now. Go where it's a little chillier, New York. What do you got in the Gotham?
I like a Lieutenant Colonel for Chad Brown. He's my top pick. I will say that I'm going to use Tense Endure and some exotics at a price. I think he's got a chance to run well with the blinkers and training well for this.
Yeah, this is a race I'm least excited about betting. I landed on El Kabir, who probably might be overbet. I just look at those pace ratings and think if he can run back to the triple digits, maybe he runs away from the field instead of laying off Classy Class, who he did put away last right. time, but
well, there's some extra speed in there as well. The last race was a concern, so you know there's a potential that he could be going there, you know, in a negative sure. form cycle. So.
Fun fact with him, he beat Royal Sun in his maiden win, who won the Battaglia last week. And we'll end at Tampa Bay Downs, their big day, Tampa Bay Derby, Stone Street Loaded. Who you got?
I got Ocean Knight first, Danzig Moon second.
All right, I'm with you on Ocean Knight, and I'm going to take a look at Hebe Johnny Be Good or Hebe Jeebies, whatever that horse is. 15-1, Sam F. Davis, maybe a key race this year. So that's it for On Point. I'll be back next week with the Rebel. Got Take Charge Brandy in there. Looking forward to seeing what you think about that.
Chance
and the other champ, American Pharaoh. Join us, won't you?